I'm Francisco Luquero. I'm currently deputy director of the Department of Information Epidemiology at EPISANT, that is the research branch of MSF. And I'm chairing the EPI working group, as Marie-Laure has presented. Last year, we have a very rich session with a lot of discussions, especially focusing in three points. It was the start of the new roadmap that WHO launched in 2017, and a lot of the discussion was around what are the support, the EPI support that could be provided to countries in order to make possible the implementation of the roadmap. And large part of the working group session went around what are the indicators that we should use to monitor the success of the roadmap in achieving control in hotspot areas, but as well in outbreaks. We have two separate discussions, one specifically on indicators for hotspot areas, and a second discussion on the role of modeling to monitor and understand the dynamic of the epidemics. A third point that was discussed last year was the research agenda. What were the research questions that were important for the EPI working group? And there was an important meeting that took place in London last July with Wellcome Trust, where all the groups put together a very rich research agenda, not only for the surveillance lab, but as well for the vaccination working group, the case management working group. So this had an interesting follow-up, and actually as part of this initiative, Wellcome Trust put call for proposals and many groups applied, and I think it's going to be a very rich project to push forward research on cholera, including epidemiological research. As Marie-Laure has mentioned, there's one interim guidance that has been published, is online, and as well, thanks to this working group that had the lead, we managed to review the Yellow Book for response to outbreaks. And now there is a new version, at least in paper. I think for the online version, we should provide the link, because some colleagues have asked me whether this can be obtained online, and I wasn't able to provide the link. But there's now a new Yellow Book for outbreak response. Then I'm just going to put a couple of slides about what I think should be the focus for this meeting that we are starting today. And Dominique will go again in the next presentation about what the new roadmap is about and where the focus of the new roadmap is. But clearly, the big focus of the roadmap is trying to tackle cholera in hotspot areas. We want to put in place multi-sectorial interventions to decrease transmission. And it's very good news that many countries are at this time revising or developing national cholera control plans. And when we are looking at what is the key element to revise and develop these national cholera control plans, an essential step, an exercise, is to identify what we call hotspots. But then, there is different approaches, different methodologies that have been used, different ways to define these areas that should be targeted. And I have put here a map of DRC, the Democratic Republic of Congo, because in DRC, this exercise was done a long time ago. And I think it's a good example of how epidemiology has been characterized in the country, with many areas clearly defined as hotspots, areas with high cholera incidence, recurrent annual seasonal peaks, and they define as well areas that are prone to outbreaks. As I said, different countries are using different methodologies, and for the EPI working group, and this is the main objective for the meeting that we are going to have these 2 days, is to openly discuss how countries are trying to identify hotspots, what are the methodologies that are used, and in a way that we can't all together become with clear recommendations about how this exercise should be done to achieve coherence between how countries are approaching the identification of hotspots. Of course, as I said before, we discussed last year already how to monitor the success of the roadmap, And as well, we will require common indicators. Lorenzo from the Secretariat is working not only in EPI indicators, but a broader range of indicators, including performance indicators of the implementation of the roadmap. And we'll go again through this topic tomorrow in the afternoon session. But just to keep in mind that our main objective for the session tomorrow, and I think that we should give priority to this point, is to become with a good exchange about what methodologies are going to propose to countries to identify and define these hotspots. It's very important because otherwise the roadmap is not sustained. We are saying that we can identify these places that are maintaining cholera transmission, and unless that we are able to find common ways to define these areas, it will be very difficult to explain to the entire community how this roadmap is going to be put in place. Then the second point, and I think we shouldn't forget about it, and this is the first axe actually of the roadmap, is the early identification and the response to outbreaks. I just wanted to warn everybody that there are big outbreaks ongoing, and some of them are regional. And I think that it's important to keep in mind this regional perspective in the spread of epidemics. We are speaking about this large outbreak that occurred in Yemen. We will discuss whole genome sequencing. But one of the things that clearly the whole genome sequencing is telling us is that these outbreaks are not national outbreaks, are regional outbreaks. And the results published from Yemen clearly illustrate that the outbreak started very much earlier in 2013, probably in Kenya, spread to Somalia, Ethiopia, and the strains arrived to Yemen. So these outbreaks are regional. We have regional outbreaks now in Nigeria, Cameroon, Niger. We have had cyclone affecting Mozambique. There has been an outbreak that has been nicely controlled by Zimbabwe. And I think that we will learn a lot about how this outbreak response can be efficient, not only to control the outbreak in the country, but regionally. We are still, in my opinion, having delays to identify the outbreaks, and as well to early describe the dynamics. Sometimes these descriptions and the understanding about how outbreaks evolve come late. And then the role of diagnostics and how we reach with the lab working group is very important. There's going to be a very important discussion about RDTs, and especially on new molecular methods, new PCR methods that can speed up the confirmation of outbreaks. Again, tomorrow we will discuss a little bit about tools that can help to better understand the dynamics of epidemics, and especially the combined analysis of epi and lab data, how modeling can help to disentangle how much cholera we have at a certain point in time. And last but not least, tomorrow in the discussion that we'll have specifically for the epi working group, we are going to discuss about how not only how better prepared, but how we can improve our response to epidemics. We are going to discuss how we can define areas that are prone to epidemics, but as well how seasonality can be used to prepare for epidemics, when interventions are more efficient to avoid outbreaks or to interrupt outbreaks, and as well we will discuss the rapid response teams. In the last outbreaks, I think that a lot of the emphasis in the rapid response teams has been coming through the WASH response, and I think that the EPI side has been left a little bit away. I think that the EPI analysis is at the core of the activities that the rapid response needs to be done, and tomorrow in the afternoon session we'll have a specific discussion about how epidemiology should be integrated or reintegrated in the rapid response teams. So that's are the objectives that we have ahead, and I hope that we have a very successful meeting to achieve those. Thank you.